Hey everyone, Casey here from Clientric. In this week's tutorial, we're going to be diving into Zoho Bookings and how you can set up the workspace and notifications. I'll see you in there. All right, now that we're logged in, we're going to go ahead and set up our workspace. So we are going to go over to the settings icon over here in the top right of our Zoho Bookings. We are going to see we have our basic setup over here on the left. This is going to be our panel that we've already talked about, and we're going to actually go ahead and start looking at our workspaces and consultations. So if we click into our workspaces, you're going to see a whole bunch of pieces of information again. So consultations, notifications, custom notifications, policies and preferences, and all of these. So we're going to go through each of these individually. Now, basic information, we can add in a workspace email. So the current name of the workspace is Demo 2 Clientric. So we can change this if we want to just Clientric, and this is going to be our workspace. We can set up an email here, so we can assign an official email address to Clientric. So I could say casey@clientric.co, and this is what all the email addresses that are going to be set up. You're going to be asked to submit a 6-digit verification code to this email, and then you're going to add that in. Now, I've already added in this email into our actual space, so this isn't going to show up. But what you do is you just type in the email you want. You're going to go over to your mail system, and it's going to give you a 6-digit code, whether that's Outlook, Gmail, doesn't matter what it is. It's going to come there, and it's going to allow you to put that information in. And then that email is going to be your workspace email going forward. All right, so now when it comes to consultations, this is where it gets a little bit fun. We have the ability to create as many consultations as we want with as many different settings as we want as well some of the time. So if we were to just select add new consultation, let's say I'm going to add in a, under the workspace Clientric, we're just going to say introduction. You can call it whatever you want. If you're familiar with Calendly or any of the Acuity is another scheduling software that's out there. If you're familiar with any of these, it's going to be very similar. So you can set up the duration you want, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 50 minutes, 1 hour, doesn't really matter. You also have the ability to set up a paid consultation. So if this is just a one-on-one, you can set that to be $100 or whatever it is and integrate it with different payment platforms as well. So that's kind of cool. Most people just do free, obviously, to get the scheduling going within their business. You can also add in some buffer time. So let's say you wanted, 30 minutes for the meeting, but you actually wanted a buffer time of say 15 minutes between each meeting. That way you're not meeting one after the other, and meetings, let's be real, typically go long. So if we have the ability to create some buffer time in there, that's going to be more effective for you and the team to make sure that you're having an effective meeting with your clients and prospects and not actually going to skip over or be late to any of them. You can now select a consultant that you want to join this consultation, so you can make group consultations if you want to, let's say sales or marketing or service. If you have different departments, you could have 3 salespeople that could take the call that they would then be either chosen randomly or they could select, the user could select who they actually want to have a conversation with. So in this case, I'm just going to select this one because that's all we have, or you could select all. Also, just a note is we have group bookings over here and we have resource bookings. So group bookings does allow a little bit of a different booking type. So there's a number of seats available. So for example, let's say you're running a class and you might have 30 people coming in or 15 people coming in to a session. So you can actually select the number of seats, kind of like a webinar. It's very similar to that. So you can actually select that and get that up and running. Let's say we wanted to put 15. You can select this box for if it's recurring, drop-in, whatever it is. Something we might use this for is actually like something like a drop-in, let's say Zoho question and answer meeting that we might want to put in. So we could create a booking specifically for that. And have the ability to create a drop-in booking type for people to come in and do all that and come in and get some solid information there. So you also have the ability to create this as a paid meeting as well. And then you can select specific consultants. And so that's the group booking. We do have another booking type here called a resource booking. And that allows us to create a resource, whether that is a meeting room, maybe it's a laptop, maybe it's a workstation. You could set all these different things up if you really wanted to. And this is where you'd go about to create a resource booking. You can also, if you wanted to do something like machinery, that would be another thing you could do if someone needed to rent that out. And you can associate prices to resource bookings as well. So we're gonna go into that in another tutorial, but we're gonna leave that one for now and come back to the one-on-one. So we don't want this to be paid, we want it to be free, we want a 30-minute meeting plus 15-minute buffer time. So we're gonna click save here. Once that is done, we have created a new consultation. So this introduction here, and we're gonna have a lot more ability granularity with this as well. So we're gonna come back to this. We're gonna continue going through the workspace first, then we're gonna come back to this introduction consultation, and then we're gonna end this one off. So the notifications over here, we can set up different types of notifications. So for the consultant or for the customer, for the consultant, meaning your team, if you want your team to get a email when there's a booking, a rescheduled meeting, a canceled meeting, a marking as completed, marked as a no-show, reminding about upcoming appointments, if you want any of that for your team, for consultants is what you want to use. For customers, you can do the exact same thing. Now these are already pre-set up and pre-selected for the booked, rescheduled, and canceled, as well as a 30-minute meeting as well prior to that. We also have the ability to set up SMS, so we can configure this through Twilio, I think, and maybe there's a couple other options. We'll dive into that in another tutorial, but you do have the ability to that once it's configured, you can go ahead and create custom SMS messages as well for each of these bookings, which is a really good idea because typically people forget that they have meetings coming up. This has happened multiple times to us. It will happen multiple times to you as well. So that's something that you might want to be aware of. To customize, you just click this customization button. The default Zoho is pretty meh, to be perfectly honest with you. It could certainly be better. So if you have your own copy you want to put in here, I highly recommend it. Putting in your logo and things like that is going to be a lot more effective than using Zoho's kind of setup that they have. So you can go in here and completely add in something new. You can insert different variables or buttons even. So for example, add to Google Calendar, Outlook, Zoho Calendar, all that kind of stuff. If they aren't being added immediately, that would be an option to help make that a little bit easier for the people who are booking meetings with you. All these variables are slightly different. So it's percent sign, variable name, and then percent sign. That's gonna be how this works. And so you can get the service name, appointment from date, all that good stuff in here. And you can put all that information in. And the subject here is just a bunch of variable names as well, as you can see. So that is how you'd insert different variables into your subject and your different messages. It's the same for each one, and it's the exact same for notifications as well. If you're just to click on that, it's all the exact same. So you just need to set this up appropriately however you want for your customers and for the consultants or your team. Now, the default sender is the original. Now, if we go back to this basic information up here, that email we put in, that is going to be where these notifications are coming from. So that default sender email is that workspace email address. So just so you're aware, if you put that in there, or you can change this to something else. So if you have other workspace emails in here that you want to send from, you can also do that. And you can also CC and copy people onto this kind of stuff, which is really cool. We also have custom functions. Now I won't go into this too much, but you have the ability to create custom functions for each of these. So you can configure custom functions to do something when a meeting is booked, for example, when a meeting is rescheduled, canceled, marked as completed, or marked as a no-show. All right, and that's all we have for the custom functions over here. We next have policies and preferences. So we have the ability to set up different policies. So scheduling intervals is every 15 minutes. Language could be based on a user's location, time zone presets. So what is the customer's local time zone? Do you want to use that? Do you want to use your time zone or lock the time zone in the booking page? You have a lot of different options here to choose from. And you have your booking confirmation page, which shows the bookings confirmation page. And lastly, we have the booking confirmation page. So when we see the show Zoho bookings confirmation page, you can show the Zoho bookings confirmation page, or you can show your own confirmation page, which you can then put in the URL. So I highly recommend you customize this a little bit. just make it a little bit more personalized on brand with your business. That is a much better way to go about doing that as well. And then pass booking details to the confirmation page so you can pull in that information and do some cool stuff with it. So that is it for this one. You can auto-generate the booking ID so you can set the prefix and the maximum digits allowed. We also have a booking notice. So the minimum booking notice, and this is very important. So it allows you to set the period after which appointment slots should be open in advance for customers. This means that you can set the minimum booking notice up to, let's say, be 24 hours. So the minimum booking notice is that they can book only 24 hours after the current time. So let's say it's a Monday at 3 p.m. You don't want to get any more bookings. You're done for the day. No one will be able to book an appointment with you until after 3 p.m. on Tuesday. That's what that means. Now, maximum booking notice is setting the period before which appointment slots should be closed for customers. Now, this is the opposite of that. That basically just means you only want to book out, you know, let's say a month down the road. They can't book out anything past 1 month. That would be the maximum booking notice. You can set terms and conditions as well here. Just put in the terms and conditions that you want. And then you have the cancellations and rescheduling policies. So this allows you to cancel and reschedule within a certain window. So let's say you don't want a cancellation last minute, so you set it so they can't cancel. This is important especially if you're doing paid consultations. So let's say that someone books with you for an hour consultation, let's say it's $500, and they cancel with you 2 minutes before your meeting. That's not super great. You prepared for it. You want to keep that as much as possible. There should be some sort of fee there because you've done some of the legwork to prep and get ready for that meeting. That being said, you could set this up so that they couldn't cancel, let's say, a day before, so there's no last minute cancellations. So that's it for this one. We're now going to move on to the Workspace booking URL page. So right now it's labeled as demo 2. We could change that and customize it to be a little bit more effective for what we're actually looking for. So we could type in, let's say, Clientric-test. Now, because this is a subdomain of my actual domain, we're not going to be able to test this out, but I can show you what my actual booking page looks like just so you can get a sense of it. So I'm going to get that for you now and we're going to put it in. All right, so I'm going to put this URL in now and you're going to see what my booking space looks like for Clientric. So this is kind of what it looks like. A lot of blue going on. You can book a meeting with Casey. You can all the different types of meetings that we have. You're booking in with Casey as well right here. You can select the date, the time that is available, and then just book meetings. So this is kind of what it looks like. You can play around with this. We're going to dive into how you can update this page a little bit in the future as we get there. So that's what it looks like in the end once you get it all set up. And now you can also embed it as a widget if you want to on a website. You can just copy the code, insert into your web page, and you're good to go. Now the booking form itself, you have the ability to update or add in different fields, I should say. Now there's a difference between guest users and registered users. Those that use Zoho Books frequently may be a registered user. The majority of people are going to be guest users. You're not going to really want to focus on registered users at all. A lot of people don't know about Zoho Bookings yet. It's not a super popular tool. It is an effective tool though. And so a lot of people, you're just going to want to focus on pulling in that information when they book a meeting with you, like name, email, contact number. You can also get a booking confirmation button. So for free appointments, you can schedule an appointment. So there's that button that you can use, and paid appointments, pay and schedule appointment as well. So those are a couple different buttons you can use as well. And then we have our booking page settings. So we can add in our logo, our title. Then if you want footer elements like contact number, email address, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, etc., you can add all that in there and it's going to show up on the footer. And then booking page themes. Okay, this is what I want to show you so you could get a sense of what a booking page theme would look like. So we do have the ability to keep the new layout. You can change it. You can update it. That's kind of what ours looks like. You can do different colors if you wanted to. So for example, this is just the kind of brown orangish color that your pictures or that your items will be. The one I showed you before was this blue and gold color. Now, unfortunately, we don't have a lot of ability to customize this as much as we wanted to. So that's the most unfortunate part out of everything. And with this modern web, you can actually choose specific colors you want. So you can change the background color, you can change the text color, you can change the button color, and you can finally change the button text color. So those are the options you do have available to you, as well as adding in, you'll see your logo in here as well. That is it. You can update page elements like title, description, image, and the button text as well. So you have some customizability there. It's not fully customizable, but you do have a decent amount. So you can choose your layout, whatever you would like to use, and see which one works best for you and your team. All right, so that is it for the workspace. I was going to go into the consultations, but this video has been long enough already, and I'm gonna go into that in another tutorial, and you're gonna see all about how we can adjust those fields and those settings as we go through. So that's it for the workspace. And please do let us know if you have any questions. If you have enjoyed this video, please make sure that you like and comment on it. It helps us reach other individuals like yourself who are looking to get a bit more knowledge on the rest of the Zoho products that are out there. So I appreciate your time, and I'll see you in the next one.